I have no doubt that the majority of us will appreciate what Rwanda has achieved, especially in the manner they process investments in that country. It's like a machine. Here in Zimbabwe, if an investor comes, we don't even know at the airport that he has arrived. We don't even know where he's going to stay in terms of accommodation. His best case is to ask the taxi driver and say, where do I find the Minister of Industry? Where do I find the Minister of Finance? Where do I find the Minister of Mines? And so on and so on.
And of course, in the course of 2 days,
you might discover where you people stay, where you can be found. And they will spend the next three weeks or so moving from one ministry to another. In some cases, if he wants to see the Minister of Agriculture, he finds the Minister of Agriculture is in Brazil, he has to wait for him to come back. It's absolutely unnecessary. There is a formula where whether the minister is in the country or the appropriate authority or stakeholder is in the country, systems must continue to function. And this is what we need to achieve. So, madam, these are my brains. They are looking forward to be fed, to be exposed to the experiences you shared with me and with the president.
Reforming the business environment is not something you do once and finish. It is something you have to do every year. In fact, for Rwanda, every beginning of the year, we are required to come up with an action plan for business reforms as the Rwanda Development Board working with the relevant ministries. We take it to cabinet, and cabinet looks at the reforms and the cabinet commits, including the ministers who are in cabinet, that they're going to reform particular areas that are relevant to them. End of the year, we must report back what has been done in terms of reforming the business. And we've been doing this at least for 10 years, but every year there's a long list of things to reform. So it's a never-ending process. The question is, how do you put in place an organization like RDB or other systems that can actually be the institution that every year their job is to just look at what can Rwanda be more competitive in? What can we improve? Because other countries are also improving. So if you want to keep being relevant, you have to also be, you know, improving, because other countries will also continue to reform their own businesses. And then service delivery, really. Making sure that as much as possible, we think about the services we're giving the private sector. Today, within the Rwanda Development Board, as I'll be showing shortly, we register companies, and we're able to take it from 3 weeks to, in 2008, just to take 3 weeks to register a company. Today takes 6 hours, and you go to one organization instead of 12, that was the case before. You fill a form, it's free, it's automated. If you don't know how to fill a form, if you don't know how to use the internet, we've built kiosks all over the country that actually you can go to and get someone to help you if you're illiterate to go into the system on the computer. But the point is, it's all automated. Whether you're able to read or not, somebody will help you, but the system is fully automated to make sure that they're consistent. And the reason for that is we found that if you decide to bring a system like automation, but you still keep a manual system, you will never take off. So you have to make sure that you go and start a system and address the challenges that might come along the way. Now, quickly, the kind of services we give. I just talked about the one-stop center where we issue work permits, visas, environmental impact assessments as well. We give notary services for documents that need to be notarized. We also have the Office of the Registrar General of Companies and Businesses in Rwanda. So all that is done there. But in addition to businesses, we also do mortgage registration. And I think I did talk a little bit about automation, but for mortgage registration, we were able to link the system with all the other systems in the country, for example, the national ID system. If you want to register a mortgage, we're not going to ask you to go and bring a copy of your ID, because the system allows you to access your ID documents and your data because it's linked to the national ID system. The system also allows you to link to the national land registries. So if you come to the Rwanda Development Board and you want to file your mortgage from a bank, when you do that, automatically the land registry also records your caveat because there's now a bank loan attached to that land. You don't have to go and physically get the land registry to do that. So this has helped us to actually merge systems and automate and really bring efficiency for the businesses that we have in the country. And then I did talk about negotiating. We all, as part of the negotiating work, we're also in charge of privatization of government assets. Again, the reasoning is, if you're privatizing a government asset, you're selling it to a private sector person or company. And so it's important that the same system that is looking for investors in the country, that has a database of investors, is the same system that taps into who wants to buy a government asset. So you shouldn't keep that separately. And that's how the privatization unit came to Rwanda Development Board. And the same thing for public-private partnerships, which used to be the Ministry of Finance, and it was also brought here because once you decide as public sector to go into a PPP, the key biggest thing is how do you structure that PPP and how do you bring the private sector to be part of that, which is again investment promotion. That's how it was also brought within the Rwanda Development Board. The last component in terms of the services we give is aftercare. When investors come, there's always going to be an issue. There's no perfect world. I think even in Singapore, which is one of the best places to do business in the world, there's always an issue an investor faces. An investor will disagree with the tax assessment they give them. They'll disagree with the land issue. They'll disagree with another investor in the country.